like a long, lonely stream. I keep running towards a dream, moving on, moving on. Like a branch on a tree, I keep reaching to be free, moving on, moving on. There's a place in the sun where there's hope for everyone, where my poor restless heart got a road. I get weary from the load, moving on, moving on. Like this tired traveler, I've been rolling since my birth, moving on. When times are bad and you're feeling sad, I want you to always remember, yes, there's a place in the sun.
On the low plains of the Rockies, we're right down there. Now, as we make our way along, follow the seawall along, come to the left of Clarence there. You'll see all the cars parked on the seawall. To the left-hand end of the cars, there's a little slipway down onto the shingle beach. See there? Lost their lives in and around Portsmouth in the heavy bombing of the Second World War. There's a square tower on the right, the home of the town's first military team will be deported at later. They were brought from Sacred Gate coming up on the right. We're making our way between two round towers. These round towers are last line of defense built by Henry VIII. And what he used to do was get his men to tow a train across the harbor to where we are now, and this would effectively close off the harbour against invasion from the sea. Remembrance of this chain, folks, without doubt the best views are going to be from any of the outer decks. There's loads of room on the outer decks, especially up on the top there. Full of pubs and clubs and lanes of that bit or the other. The only thing was you stood a very good chance of getting a press gang. Find yourself as a volunteer on board one of them. Nowadays it's a highly desirable residential area. Although Dave, our crew downstairs, found me, Lucy Lashley still lives there. We made our way into the port. The land's superb views across the harbour and across to the police boats. Make sure you give her a friendly wave. And that way we can get a little bit closer than we should do. But if you do wave to the police on the police boats, bear in mind these are iron, first of the ironclad backers. Warrior coming up on the right. Right down the Victoria Dock in London. 9,210 tons, it revolutionised the Victoria. Controls all shipping movements around this very busy port, all controlled by VHF radio, radar and closed circuit television. Portsmouth, the busiest ferry port in the United Kingdom, counting the Isle of Wight, on one of the Russian cruisers of the President of Russia, President Khrushchev. It led to a diplomatic incident. Some say this was the start of the Cold War. 190 crew. She's 500 feet, has a 7,000 mile range. A Mark 9 Vickers 4.5 inch gun at the forward end. McDonnell Douglas Harpoon missiles. 220mm Vulcan Phalanx cannon. Seawolf missiles and a Vickers Mark 9 4.5 inch gun right on the foredeck. The ship forward of that's HMS Time. That's a fishery protection vessel, one of four of this class. HMS Time keeps on the fishing fleet not only of the United Kingdom but also the European community. Checks the Nensible, the sister ship which served then in the Falklands, went to the scrapyard last June, and the illustrious other sister ship, the Ark Royal, is laid up, and hopefully we'll get a view of that in a minute. Go and get the guard away. That's it. Smile, he's got a machine gun. 20,000 tons with a crew of 1,200 officers and men. She was originally carrying 12 Sea Harrier vertical takeoff planes and 9 Sea King helicopters. She's now been converted into a helicopter carrier. Has goalkeeper guns in for it, just forward of the after funnel. These are 30mm multi-barreled anti-missile guns, designed to protect the ship against missiles and planes. You see, she has a ski ramp type flight deck at the forward end. This was to facilitate the easy takeoff of the Sea Harriers. If they go forward and vertical at the same time, they save a considerable amount of fuel, they get airborne quicker, and they stay airborne for a longer period. HMS Endurance, she had a technical problem down off the Falklands just over 2 years ago. Now she's nearly on hold. She's an icebreaker. She carries the task of the Royal Marine Commandos. But her place has been taken by HMS Protector. So we're not quite sure what's going to happen to the Endurance there. That's one of only two Royal Naval ships that's not grey. Now as we start to come about, folks, up in the corner here we have HMS Cumberland. This is HMS Cumberland. She's a Type 22 warship, and she is one of four. And she's been lined up like the other three, part of the defence cuts. She weighs 5,000 tons of crew, 40 officers and men. And we're not quite sure what's going to happen to her. But over the top of her, just inside the quay wall, is the sister ship. Is a Type 82 destroyer that was built to escort Vikings. She remained in service for 16 years. She was then withdrawn from service, permanently moored where you could see her on the right. Her engines have been removed, the engine rooms turned into classrooms, and the rest of the ship is used for training and accommodation by the very tough Royal Naval Training School of HMS Excellent, which is based on Whale Island at the helicopter cabin. A very good multi-role vessel. We might know why along. past the oil field jetty on the right. We didn't hear much of the fort until the 12th century, by which time there was a considerable fleet in residence. Henry VIII fortified the sea walls in Portsmouth.